Hello everyone. In the first lecture, we had discussed about what is mechanism, what is the machines, what is the link, what is the kinematic pair, and also concern with the kinematic change and concern with the mechanism. Okay, today in second lecture, we had discussed about more about the inversion of mechanism. Before going to the inversion of mechanisms, we had start about recall also recall the all the things we'll cover in the first lecture. So we know that what is the types of link. It is the rigid link, flexible link, and fluid link. Also, we had too much discuss about the difference between the mechanism, machines, and structures also in the first lectures. Okay. Now, what is the kinematic pair? Kinematic pairs in which the completely constrained motions, okay, also in completely constrained motions, successfully constrained the motions, kinematic pair according to the types of the relative motions. We know that that is the sliding pair, turning pair, rolling pair, screwing pair, spherical pair, and according to the types of contact, lower pair and higher pair, and another is the according to self closed pair and force pair, okay. We know that the, what is the kinematic change. The, when the kinematic pair is coupled in such a way that the that last link is joined to the first link, we know that that is the call as a kinematic. That is the call as a kinematic change. In which kinematic change, the change will be converted into the mechanism and also converted into the machines. Okay, mechanism will be converted into machines. But what is the mechanism? Mechanism that means what? The link of kinematic change fixed. One link, one kinematic change will be a fixed, and the change will be a going to its a mechanism. A mechanism with the four link, that is called as a simple mechanism, and more than four links, that is called as a compound mechanism. We know that. And lastly, we had most important theory for the exam point of view, as well as another inversion of mechanism point of view, that is called as a number of degree of freedom. That means what in design or analysis of the mechanism, of the most important concern is the number degree of freedom of the mechanism. It is defined as number of input parameter which must be independent control in order to bring the mechanisms. It is useful for the engineering purpose. We know that. Okay, so that is the concern. That is the number of mechanism in which we had discussed about the two plane mechanism application, that is called as a catch basin creations. In from this catch basin creation, we can derive the one equations n equal to 3 l minus 1 2 j and 2j minus h. From these equations, we can find out the plane mechanism's movability, freedom of movability. That means what, how much it will be a moving. Okay, so that is called as a catch basin creations mechanism. And from the catch basin creations, we can define the all things at this call as a number of link, and according to the number of joints, we can derive and conclude the number of movability. Okay, so in this regard, we all discuss about in a previous lecture about the catch basin creations, and lastly, we had from the catch basin creations, we can derive another application, that is called the Gilbert's creations. Okay. From this Gilbert's creation, it is the concern with the catch basin creation. But when the number of degree will be h will be a zero, and n will be converted into the l. Okay, that time it will be converted into the Gilbert creations for the plane mechanisms. Okay, so now today we will discuss about the inversion of mechanism. Okay, we had already discussed that one of link is fixed in the kinematic chain, that is called as mechanism. Okay, we know that. So we can obtain the many mechanism as the number of links in kinematic chain by fixing the link. Okay, that means what, we know that link will be converted into the pair. Okay, that is two link will be going to in a two will be connected to each other, that is called as a pair. Fixed link, first link will be added to the last link, that is called as a chain. Okay, and kinematic change will be a fix one by one getting the fixing, and it will be converted into the fixing the links, and that is will be converted into the mechanism. This method of obtaining the different mechanism by fixing the different link, that is called as a kinematic change. It is known as an inversion of mechanism. Simply in short, in a one sentence, what is the inversion of mechanism? It is the fixing a link in mechanism that is called as the inversion of mechanism. Okay, so inversion of mechanism, that there is a types of kinematic chain, four bar chain or quadric cyclic chain. Okay, another is the single strider crane chain and double strider crane chain. Okay, so that is the four bar chain. Four bar chain, that means what, more than four chain will be affixing to each other, that is called as a four bar, that is called as a four bar chain mechanism. Okay, in which these types of, this is the simplest types of kinematic chain, in which the four rigid link are connected by the four pin joint. Okay, that means what, four rigid link by that is the, in which the four chain, that means what, four link four joint. Okay, in four bar chain or quadrat cyclic chain, that means what, in which the four bar chain is a four turning pair, like one and two form the running pair, two and three for the secondary turning pair, and three four will be a third turning pair, and four one will be a four turning pair. Okay, so that is the four turning, 1 2 2 3 3 4 and 4 5. We can more understand in the another mechanism. So that is, in short, that is the four bar chain or quadratic cyclic chain, that is called as a four bar chain. Single strider, another is the type of the single strider crank mechanism, in which the one slider crank chain will be used, that is called as a single slider. Whenever we use the double strider crank, that is called as a double slider. So that is the types of the kinematic chain. Okay, four bar chain, single strider crank chain and double strider chain. Okay, now first of all, we will going to the inversion of the bar chain mechanism. Okay, inversion of the four bar chain mechanism, first of all, is a beam engine crank and lever mechanism. Okay, from this beam engine we can understand here, that is the first link number one, it is the fixed here. Okay, and link number one is fixed, another crank number, link number two is called as a crank, another is the link number three, and another is the link number four, though that is called as a piston rod and cylinder arrangement. Okay, when it will be used for the boring points of view, there, whenever we boring for the purposing or boring or drilling purpose, that time the beam engine will be used. In this mechanism, how can we say that there is the call as the inversion of four bar, that is the four change will be used here. What is the mechanism here? The four bar link number one is fixed. Okay, A to B is the crank. Okay, crank will be rotated here 360 degree. Okay, that time the link number three will be oscillated in this directions. Okay, so it will be moving in this directions according to the link number three. A link number four, that is called as a lever. Okay, link number four will be oscillating also in this directions. Okay, so link, according to the link number four, in link number four end, the piston rod and cylinder will be attached here. So piston rod and cylinder will be attached here, so it will be moving in this directions. So from this beam engine, we can boring or pouring a soil. Okay, so this is the, that is called as a beam engine. First of all, that is the call as a four bar chain, in four link will be used. Link number one is fixed here. Link number two is in a rotated in the 360 degree, that is called as a crank. A to B is the link number two. It will be rotated in the 360 direction. The link number three will be oscillated in this direction. According to this directions, link will be four in this directions. So at the end of the lever, pistons roll and cylinder will be attached here. So in this directions, it will be piston rod and cylinder will be a pouring and solid, pouring and drilling the soil. Okay, so that is called as a beam engine. Okay, so that is the simplest mechanism of the four bar chain or beam engine. Another is the concern with the coupling rod of the locomotive double crank mechanism. Okay, coupling of the locomotive double crank mechanism, that means what here. It will be a fixed link, will be a link number one will be a fixed here. A to B is the link number one is the fixed. B to C is the link number two. It will be a rotated in the 360 directions. Okay, and link number three is in the oscillating directions. There is the two, as shown in figure, there is the two wheel. If wheel A and wheel B is we can show in the figure. So according to the link number three, it will be a rotated in the 360 directions. Okay, So that is the simple locomotive types. That is the double crank mechanisms, in which what will be the mechanism? Link number one will fix, link number two rotate 360 directions. Okay, so according to the this direction, link number three will be oscillated, and at this one from this front wheel, it will be a power transmission to the rear wheel. That is called as a double motive, that is called as a double crank mechanism and coupling rope of the locomotive. Another is the what indicator mechanism. What indicator mechanism, that means what, in which fixing, what indicator mechanism is a double lever mechanism, in which two lever will be used. Okay, double lever, that means what, two lever will be used. Link number one is here attached. Okay, link number two is here. Okay, and link number three is connected with E point. C to E is the link number three, and link number four is concerned with this link. Okay, so in which the rotations of the link, when A will be a fix, B will be a moving to the B dash, C will be a moving to the C dash, D will be a moving to D dash, F will be a moving to D, E F will be moving to the F dash, E will be moving to the E dash. That time cylinder and plunger will be a moving in the upper and downward directions. Okay, that is the call as a what indicator mechanisms. Okay, what indicator mechanisms? It will be a concern with the four bar chain mechanisms. Okay, so another is a single slide. Another is the concern with the single slider crank mechanism. Okay, in this mechanism, there is single slider pair or three, that is called as a turning pair. Slider, that means what, it will be a moving in a sliding positions, and turning, that means what, it will be a moving in a turning or rolling positions. Okay, turning pair. The link one is fixed. Okay, we know that the link one is the fixed. Link two is the crank. Okay, from this figure we can show that is the crank. Link number two is the fixed, and link three is the connecting rod, and the link number four is the piston. Okay, that is called as a cross header. That is called as a piston. Okay, cross header, that is piston. This mechanism is convert rotary motions into the reciprocating motions, and vice versa. In IC engine, reciprocating motions convert to rotary motion by using the same mechanisms. Okay. This mechanism is a very simple mechanism, single slider crank mechanism. In exam point of view, this is also most important theory for the GTU as well as midsem point of view, in which frame link one is the fix, link two is the crank, that is the rotating in the 360 direction. In connecting rod, it will be rotating in this direction. So link number four will be automatically move in this direction. Okay, so it will be this mechanism convert the rotary motions into the reciprocating motions. It will be used in the IC engine. This is called as a single slider crank mechanism. Okay, now inversion of single slider crank mechanism, that means what, we know that what is the inversion of mechanism, in which we can fixing the link one by one, and that will be, it will be a converted into by fixing the one by one fixing of the link. That time inversion will be a converted, that is called as a inversion of mechanism. That is called as a pendulum pump. That means what, here the we know that this is cylinder, link number one is here, A to B, that is called as a link number one, that is the crank link number two, connecting rod link number three. But inversion of mechanism, that is the two fixed link, that is link number four, and link number four is also cylinder. Okay, so pendulum pump, that means what, when the sliding pair is fixed, the mechanism is known as a pendulum pump. Okay, up to the now we cannot fixing a sliding pair, but in this figure we can fixing a sliding pair, that is called as a mechanism of the pendulum pump. Okay, link number two rotate, link number three is oscillating about the C point, and the pistons attached to the pistons link, and that is called as a reciprocating in the cylinder. Okay, so that is called, this is the concern with the pendulum pipe, or that is also called as a bull engine. Okay, so in which link number one will be attached to the here, link number will be a crank, link number three, but here the sliding pad will be a fixed. Whenever we get the sliding pair will be a fixed, that time it will be a pendulum pump. Okay, now another is the oscillating cylinder engine. Oscillating cylinder engine, it is name is indicate there, here cylinder will be oscillating. Okay, So oscillating cylinder engine, that means what? In this mechanism, link number 3 is fixed. Okay, we can show, we can show in this figure. Link number 3 is fixed. Okay, now link number 2 is rotated. Link number 2 is rotated 360 degree, and the link reciprocating and link number 4 oscillating to the pin A. Okay, so here link number 3 is fixed. Link number 2 is the rotating in this direction, 360 direction. According to the link number 2, piston rod is oscillating in this direction. Okay, in the cylinder, link number 4, that is the fix. Okay, so that is called as a oscillating cylinder engine. In this mechanism, in up to the now what we had studied, that is the only we cannot oscillating inversion of mechanism, only fixing the link, that is called as a inversion of mechanism. But two, more than two link will be a fix in the previously pendulum pump. But here the link number 3 will be a fix, and according to the link number 2, it will be a rotated in the 360 direction. According to this direction, piston rod will be moving in this direction, and cylinder and crank will be rotated in the this direction. That is called as a oscillating cylinder engine. Okay, now another is the concern with the rotary internal combustion engine, or that is called as a GNOM engine. Okay, rotary internal combustion engine or GNOM engine, GNOM engine, that means what? Okay, this mechanism is used for the multi-cylinder engine. Okay, up to the now what we had said is only one cylinder, and one piston arrangement will be shown in up to the now in previously mechanism. But in a rotary engine or combustion engine, GNOM engine, this mechanism is used for the multi-cylinder engine. It consists of the several cylinder in one plane and or relove about the fixed center, that is called as a O. Okay, see, we can see here the figure, that is called as a O. Here the multi-cylinder arrangement in the according to the another directions. Okay, so as shown in figure, that is the call as a this is the fixing the link, that is the call as a fixing the crank number link 2. Without the fixing link, that is not called as a inversion of mechanism. So we can hear the fixed link number 2. About the O point, all the pistons will be connected in the same plane, that is called as a O, and connecting rod, pistons and cylinder engine here. And link number, connecting rod is a link number 4, piston is a link number 3, and cylinder is a link number 1. Okay, so this mechanism is for the multi-cylinder engine. It consists of several cylinder in the one plane, and all the revolves about the fixed point. So that is called as a multi-rotary engine, combustion engine for the multi-purpose engine. Okay. So now another is the crank and slotted lever mechanism. Crank and slotted lever mechanism, that means what? It will be used in the shaper machine. Okay, different types of machines you have studied in the MP1 and MP2. But most important concept for the crank and slotted lever mechanism, that means what? It is the purpose for the cutting purpose. Okay, if you are cutting the plane, that is called as a cutting stock, but that the ram will be a move in the, that is called as a return stock, as shown in figure here. That is the ram. Okay, so on the ram, that is the tool will be added at the end of the ram, and here the we can put a job. Okay, we can start the machines. That time the ram will be moving in this direction, that is called as a cutting stock, and according to the cutting stock, it will be move in this direction, that is called as a concern with the return stocks. Okay, so in this mechanism, the link 1 is slider. Okay, the link 1 is, that is called as a slider. Crank is the link 2, that is called as a crank, and link number 3 is called as a fixed, that is called as a also concerned with this a fixed link, that is the in the upward eye. Link number 4 is the slotted bar, that is called as a link number 4. The line of stock is, that is called as a line of stock is perpendicular to the BC. Proceed this mechanism mostly used for the shaping machines and slotting machines. Okay, we know that what is the shaping machine and slotting machine. Okay, we can put one slot in a job. Okay, we can use the slotting or shaping. Okay, so that time the cutting stock and return stock is most important. In cutting stock, it will be taking the more time, but return stock, it will be taking the less time. So it will be used for the crank and slotted lever mechanisms. Okay, so it will be used for the crank and slotted lever mechanism. Another is the concern with the Whitworth quick return motions mechanism. It is the one of the same mechanism, but here the link number one we can show is the link number one is the slotted bar. Link number two is the concern with the fixed link. Link number three will be in the rotating motions. Link number four is a slotting motion. It will be moving in this direction. Ram will be moving in this direction. That is called as a cutting and return stock. But most important criteria for the timing purpose. Okay, cutting in the cutting stock it will be taking more time. In the return stock it will be taking the less time. Okay. So thank you very much. Today we will in this lectures concerned with the inversion of mechanism. Thank you all of you.